But also city's 2015 candidate election for mayor, city council, but also city school board. We'd like to start this meeting off tonight with a greeting from Mr. Bob Elder, with the Central Christian Leadership Conference. Mr. Elder, if you come up.
Evening, I'm Bob Elder with Southern Christian Leadership Conference, spelled out the chapter. We wanted to open this, and we are sponsors, main sponsors, I guess, with a little bit of history of the SCLC national history and also the local chapter history. Beginnings of the national organization of Southern Christian Leadership Conference will be traced back to Montgomery Bus Boycott, which you, many of you may remember, began December 5th, 1955, lasted 381 days, and ended in December 1956 with the desegregation of the Montgomery City bus system. As bus boycotts spread across the South following the success of the Montgomery action, Dr. King, Dr. Ralph Abernathy, and others determined they needed to form a regional organization that would coordinate the activities to support the civil rights activities across the South. In Atlanta, on January 10th and 11th, 1957, 60 persons from 10 states formed a group they called the Southern Leadership Conference on Transportation and Nonviolent Integration. Further organizing was done February 57 in Washington, and at that meeting, officers were elected and executive board of directors appointed. The first officers were Dr. King, as president, Reverend C.K. Steele of Tallahassee, Florida, vice president, Dr. Ralph Abernathy, the financial secretary, Reverend T.J. Jemison of Baton Rouge, the secretary, and attorney Ian Augustine of the Royal Current name, Southern Christian Leadership Conference, was established at their first convention in Montgomery, Alabama, August 57. National governing objectives established are as follows: promote spiritual principles within our membership and local communities, to educate youth and adults in the areas of personal responsibility, leadership potential, and community service, and to ensure economic justice and civil rights in the areas of discrimination and affirmative action. Also, to eradicate environmental classism and racism wherever it exists. SCLC challenges all people of goodwill of every persuasion to believe in the principles espoused by Dr. King to join us in our mission. The Valdosta chapter of SCLC was initially born as the People's Tribunal. After the unexplained death of Willie James Williams while in custody of the Lowndes County Sheriff's Department, following a routine traffic stop, the tribunal was formed in 1998 and has been the principal civil rights organization for many years, since its founding in Lowndes County under the leadership of Reverend Floyd Rose. In 2013, the tribunal changed its organizational status to become the Valdosta chapter of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference. It has been the tradition of the organization since its founding to provide a forum during each election cycle for candidates for public office to present their vision and desire to be elected, and for citizens to ask questions regarding their concerns. Valdosta SCLC is pleased to provide this forum tonight. It says thank you to each and every one of